Yeah, today is full body workout. So we are using our body weight strength for this workout. We're gonna work the whole body. We are doing 15 reps each side, 10 moves, and 2 rounds. So first we want to warm up. So I want you to do 10, well, let's just go ahead and do 15. 15 jumping jacks. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, knees are soft, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, here's my workout, Courtney, 14, 15, the dryer, good for you that don't know. All right, let's do some backwards arm swings. Loosen up your shoulders, because yes, we're going to do push-ups. All right, I don't know how many. Just open and cross. Open wide, cross. Open, cross. Stretch that chest out, squeeze those shoulder blades together. All right. Good to go. Now, we're going to gently kick up, stretch hamstrings, and switch. A little tight at first. We're going to go on the right side. Still have to warm up the hips, even though yes, we are going to do squats. The best way to warm up for a squat is to squat. So this time, keep it in a top range because we're just warming up. Sitting back is where you can practice your form. You're going to have your weight in your heels. You should be able to wiggle your toes. You don't want to arch your back too much. So just slightly tuck the tailbone under, pull the belly button in. You want to make sure when you're squatting that your knees stay pressed outward. It's always helpful to find a spot on the wall. And I have no idea how many, so 2 more if that sounds good. And done. All right. You can kick your butt, warm up those thighs, stretch them out. So anyway, we're going to first start with squats. So we're going to do 3 different ways. We're going to do hip width, we're going to do wide sumo, and we're going to do narrow. So 15 each. So first, just start at a comfortable width for you. Make sure you fix your leggings. All right, so pretend you have a chair behind you. If you want to, you can do it in front of the couch so that in case you were to lose your balance, you're just sitting right down. But that is what you're supposed to be doing, is sitting your butt way far back like you're gonna sit in a chair, weight in the heels, go as deep as you are able, and come back up. 1, 2, again, it's at your own pace. 3, 4, press the knees out. 5, 6, 7, try to keep the chest proud. 9, 10, 11, 12, squeeze, 13, 14, 15. Next move is chair pose. So all you yogis out there, you already know, you're gonna try to keep your arms straight as much as you can, shoulder width apart, and you're gonna sit back. So the idea is to not let the arms come down too much, but they naturally will. So you're just gonna squat down and come back up. Same thing, sitting your butt back for a chair. We're gonna do 15. So here we go. We're gonna go down. 1, squeeze. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, belly in. 9, chest proud. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. All right, extra wide, feet are angled outward. This time is a little bit different. You need to stand against a wall because you're not sitting back like you normally would with a squat. You're actually gonna come straight down. So imagine yourself between two panes of glass, and you're just gonna come straight down. The knees are gonna push outward and back and come down wherever you can. Squeeze the inner thighs, squeeze the butt. 15, whatever is comfortable for your hands is fine. You're gonna come down. 1, 2, 3. Press the knees out. 4. Weight in the heels. 5. Straight down. 6. 7. Squeeze. 8. 9. 10. 11. Whoop, 12. Lose your balance. 13. It happens. 14, 15. What that means is I need to slow down. Form is most important. All right, so legs should be nice and warm. Now, we are gonna go into what I call a round the world lunge. So basically, we're gonna step forward into a lunge, together, side, together, and back. All right, so I'm gonna break it down this first round. Each one counts as one. We're going to 15, we'll do both sides. All right, so when you come forward, nice wide step forward as if you're stepping over a log. Your legs are hip width apart. You're gonna bend that back knee. Your front knee automatically will come with it, and you're coming straight down. So your hip and your knee should be over each other. And your knee and your ankle should essentially be in line with each other. You're gonna tuck your tailbone under, core tight, that will help you keep your balance. Then when you push, when you come up, push back, push off the heel, together. This may seem simple, most of you guys know how to do a lunge, but I often see it done incorrectly. Side lunge, step out wide as you can side. This leg stays straight. You wanna keep your foot flat, you don't want it rocking up. Keep it flat. And you're just bending at the hip and coming down. When you come up, push together. And then back, same thing. You're stepping nice and wide as if you're stepping over something. There's a big log or something in between your legs. Bend that back knee, come down, tuck the tailbone under, belly button in. And then this time, you push off your toes. All right? So here we go. I should have just counted that, but we're not going to. So here we go. We're gonna take it forward, together, side, together, back, together. Now your range of motion is gonna be different than mine and the next person. That's 6. And back, that's 9. And back, 12, one more each. And back, 15, all right. Other side, here we go. A little awkward to switch. And back, 3, front, side, and back, 4, 6, duh. And back, front, side, and back, front, whatever feels good with your arms, no right or wrong. One more, and back, together. All right, shake it out. Next round, we're gonna go a little faster, and you will get some cardio with these movements. All right. Moving on, if you have a towel or a mat, bring that for your knees if you so choose. Because yes, we are going to do push-ups. You're going to come on down to the ground. with our push-ups, we're gonna be doing three ways with them as well, just like with the squats. So we've got, well, similar to the squats. So we've got your normal push-up. So that's just kind of a little outside shoulder width, wherever's comfortable. You're gonna have your shoulders over your wrists. Sometimes it helps to slightly turn the hands out. And you're just gonna knees or toes, everybody's level is different. You're starting in a plank, knees or toes, come down wherever's comfortable, push up. Okay, then we're gonna go extra wide, same thing, push up. And then we're gonna alternate one narrow, one wide. So on that narrow side, you're gonna have your elbows skim your rib cage. So we're working the triceps and the chest. So essentially this works all of the upper arm. So if you're ready, let's do it. So regular push-up, whatever width is comfortable for you, just outside the shoulder. Here we go. You're gonna find a spot a couple of inches away from your hands and bring it down where you can. One, two, go at your own pace. Three, belly button in. Four, five, six, seven, squeeze. Eight, squeeze that chest. Nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. All right, lean it back or sit it back, stretch. Now we're gonna go wide. Stretch it out, this floor is a little hard on my hands. All right, so a little extra wide. I will tell you that if you use the couch or a coffee table, it makes it a little bit easier. So the more you incline, the easier it is. So if it is hard for you, even on the knees, to do a push-up, give yourself an incline. Use the couch, back of the couch, coffee table, even the wall, and that will help. And that's how you can build up to a standard push-up. All right, here we go, extra wide, 15. Go at your own pace. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, breathe, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Sit it back. And yes, you're gonna hear me breathe, sorry. All right, here comes the hard one. One narrow, one wide, and then switch. We're just gonna do 16 so that we're even, all right? Again, same thing, you can use an incline if you need to. The narrow arm, the elbow skims your shoulder blades. So here we go. One, switch, two, switch, three, switch, four, switch, five, switch, six, switch, seven, switch, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, last one, 16. Whew, all right, set it back, stretch it out. Well, I'm gonna tell you three ways. So you can do modified or extra modified tabletop. So just where your knees are under your hips, tabletop, or you can come into more of a plank on your knees or toes. So what we're doing is we're going down, down, up, up. So you're gonna come down, down, press up, up, alternate down, down, up, up. All right, we're gonna go to 16 so that we're even. So pick whichever way you wanna try to challenge yourself. So you can start out one way and you can switch to another if you need to. So here we go. Get in position, whichever way you choose. Belly button is in tight. And down, down, up, one. Down, down, up, two. Down, down, up, three. Down, down, up, four. Down, down, up, five. Down, down, up, six. Down, down, up, seven. Down, down, up, eight. Down, down, up, nine. Down, down, up, 10. Down, down, up, 11. Got it. Down, down, up, 12. Down, down, almost there. 13. Down, down, up, 14. Down, down, 15. Woo, down, down, up, up. Woohoo. All right. Oh, I was thinking how out of shape I am. But anyway, this is why it's good for everybody. Good for me to do a class. Moving on. Two more exercises, then we're going to switch back or start over our round. So we are going to, while we're here, I guess let's just go ahead and do our back. So we're going to lie on our stomach, and it's a Superman. I'm going to turn sideways. And hopefully, most of you probably already know what that is. So you're going to lie on your stomach, arms are out. They can be out in front. They can be out to the side like a field goal. Or you can put them right under you if you need a little help. So basically, we're going to be lifting our chest up off the ground and our legs at the same time. The goal is to get your knees off and your chest off. And you're going to squeeze everything on your backside. So you're going to feel it in your lower back. You're going to feel it in your butt, you're going to feel it in your hamstrings, everything. Now, you want to make sure that you're staring at the ground so that your chin is tucked and you're not extending your neck. Alright, so if I sound muffled, I'm sorry, but I'm trying to keep the proper position. So get in position, you're stretching out long and lean, squeeze those glutes, and here we go, we're going to lift. One, two, up and down, three, 4, 15, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, the last one, 15. Alright, roll it over. This time we're going to do the Pilates roll up. You're going to start with tucking your chin, rolling your head up. Roll the chest up, our shoulder blades off the ground, and roll all the way up and reach for the ceiling, and then slowly roll it back. All right, so here we go. We're gonna reach the hands up, roll, 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 extend, come back down slow. One, two, inhale once you come down, exhale to roll up. Inhale once you're up, exhale when you come down. Three. Four, slow. Five, don't let your feet come off the ground or your heels. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, I hope you're breathing with me, 14, and last one. Here we go, hip width squats, 15, 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, seven. Squeeze. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Narrow. Reach the arms to the sky. Chair pose. 1, 2. Belly in. 3, 4, 5. You won't squat as deep because your legs are narrow. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. All right, step extra wide, toes turned out, straight down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, you got it. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, here we go. So the lunges, right foot first, step forward, side, and back. 1, 2, to do 15, we go to 5, 3, 4, slow it down, 5, switch, left forward, 1, forward, side, and back. Two more. Last one. All right. Push up ten. Try to hurry. Here we go. Regular push up. Wherever you're comfortable. 15. 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Stretch it. Now extra wide. Straighten up. Alright. Extra wide. Again, you can go into more of a tabletop if you get tired. No shame in that, I might have to. 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Stretch it back. 1 narrow, 1 wide. So this one's harder. You get a tabletop or knee plank or toes. So here we go. 16 to make it even. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You got it, keep going. 14, 2 more. 15, 16. Hold on, go on. All right, up, up, down, down with the arms. 16 to make it even. Tabletop position, plank on knees or plank on toes. Here we go. Down, down, up, up, down, down. 2, 4, down, down, 5, or 6, sorry, 8, halfway, up, 10. Slow down. 12. 14. Almost there. Down, down, up, up, down, down, up. 16. I think I was trying to rush it. All right. Now, back to lower back or back side, and then crunches. So on your belly, Superman lifts. Arms out or wherever you're comfortable. Here we go. Squeeze the glutes and lift. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Shoulder blades pull down. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Whoop! And an extra to crow on. I got carried away. All right. 15 roll ups. Flip over. Last one. We got this. Tuck that head. Roll it up. Reach. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Halfway. Six more. Five more. Four. Three. Two. Last one, you got it. Whew. All right. Now, if you are not tired, you can go for a round three if you like, but I'm gonna stretch. So stretch with me if you're ready. Long and lean, legs straight, arms straight above the head. Now with your legs, you're just gonna kind of walk them. So lengthen one leg really long and then switch. So you're just kind of rotating or dropping the hip bone down. Feels good. On the lower back. All right. I'm going to hug one knee into the chest. Another stretch for the low back. Straighten that leg up towards the ceiling, wherever you can. Grab behind the thigh, behind the calf. Touch your toes, you can do that. Stretch in the hamstring, flex that foot, get a little calf stretch in there too. Now that foot's in the air, cross over the opposite knee. Press your knee away from you, opening up that hip. Now pull that knee over and across towards your opposite shoulder. Get a stretch in the glute. And release that across foot down. Other knee, bring it in towards the chest, give it a hug. You can hold underneath the bend of the knee or on top of your shin, whatever's comfortable. Try to relax your body. Take that ankle, cross it over the other leg, press that knee away, opening up the hip. Now you're going to bring that knee up and over towards the opposite shoulder. Thank you. And I forgot, so you're gonna straighten that leg up towards the ceiling. Can't skip the hamstring. Flex that foot for a little extra stretch. Try to get that knee as straight as you can. Release it down. All right, feet and knees are together. Let those knees fall to one side, keeping the shoulders flat on the ground. You're gonna open your arms up into the letter T. You're gonna turn your head away from your knees. Get a nice stretch across the chest. And you should also feel it in your lower back, getting a little twist. All right, tighten up that belly and bring those knees back to the center. Readjust if you need to. And then let the knees fall to the other side slowly. Head looks away. Try to keep your shoulders anchored to the ground. You may find that one side is a little bit harder and the other a little stiffer. All right, tighten up that belly, bring your knees back. And you're gonna roll them over to your belly. You do a little stretch for our belly. And something's good for the spine. Hands are underneath the shoulders. You're just gonna press up onto your elbows. Shoulder blades are pulled down your back. Your shoulders are rolled back and down. Put a little pressure in your lower back. You gotta work on spinal mobility. Come down. You can do that again, or you can have your palms flat and press through. Straighten the arms. Get a little more extension. Stretching the abdominals. And come back down. This time you're going to push back into child's pose. So come up. If you can, sit on your knees. Knees are nice and wide. Sit on the heels, I mean. Once you're there, come down to the ground. And reach out as far as you can. And really push your hips back onto those feet. Walk your arms on the one side. We're just going to stretch the side of our back. Slowly back to the center. Walk it over to the other side. Stretch. Center. And you can just come back up. And you guys are done. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed it. You're sweating as much as I am.